So, children of class 9th, because of technical issue, we rejoined all, but we are able to rejoin. Thank God for that. So, let's continue. Models, fine. A definition I have written here. I was discussing with you all that a model verb is a type of verb that is used to indicate modality. Now, what is modality? Means likelihood, permission, ability, request, obligation, advice, etc. Fine, more than that, more parameters are there. So we definitely, models are a very important part of parts of speech in English. Fine, so this is required. And I would be sharing the screen with you all, showing the usage of particular, you can say, model. In which circumstance we apply, you can say should, where do we use will, where do we use have to, fine. Now, examples of models. Firstly, I told you what is a model verb, clear? And what do they indicate? Secondly, I told you what do they indicate. So, clear? What is a model? Number one, what do they indicate? Number two, now, example of models. Now, examples are which words are known as models? There are many. I would be writing a few only. Shall, like shall is the base form, then we change it also. Should, then we have will. This is the base form, which changes to would also. Then we have to, need to, ought to, can is the base form, and then we have could, shall, should, will, would, have to, need to, ought to, fine, ought to, can, could, in that way. Fine, many more are there. Dare, endless list is there. Dare is also one of the model verb. Clear? So this is just, I'm just writing etc. Means there are more. Got it? You need to write it in the fear notebook only. You will be, when you will be sending a notebook, it should be written what is a model verb, what does it indicate, and examples of model verbs. Then now I'm going to share the usage. Okay, beta? I would be sharing the screen with you all now. And beta, keep on noting down side by side. Show me your notebooks firstly, jaldi se jo dikha sakte hain, jaldi se. A quick view of your notebooks. Titiksha, Dhairya, Harmeet, Prachi. Very good. Ashna, Riyanshika. Clear, fine. Just, I'm just checking whether you're writing or not. Let me share the screen with you all now. Beta, avoid seeing these ads because on sites we have a number of ads, but you will be concentrating on, fine. I will be highlighting the content also if possible. Some sites allow, some sites do not allow. So model auxiliaries. Now don't get panic, you know, after reading what is this auxiliaries. They're helping verbs only. So model auxiliaries are verbs such as can, must, could, would. I'm reading from here, okay? Definition. Which are used with main verbs to express such ideas, such possibility, permission, necessity, and obligation. I already told you what is, what do they indicate? What do these model verbs indicate? Okay. So we will be starting from must and have to. What you will do? if you can note down, or you can take the screenshot also of usage, that will help you. But if you're not, you're having grammar book, that is also enough for you. Fine. In the grammar book, beta, you can see on page number 208, if I show you, on page 208, they have given the usage of models along with examples. Clear and properly given it is. So you need not note down this all. Clear? You have grammar book for that. I would be giving you exercises to solve. That is our concentration. You understand the concept from grammar book and from the screen which I have shared with you. Okay? Excuse me. Okay. Must. Must is used for all persons in the present and future tenses. Clear? All persons. It can be used with you also, I also, we also. Some verbs are there which are used with particular persons. How many persons are there in English language? Three. I, you, and third person about whom we are talking. He, she, it, they, etc. Clear? So must is used for all persons in the present and future. And in the negative form of must is mustn't or must not. Interrogative form is must I. Clear? And we won't be reading all the things they have given in abundance. So we will be just in the usage where we use this. We will be concentrating on usage. This is the usage, beta. Must is used to express obligation. You can just write to express obligation where must is written. Clear? You must obey your parents. You must go to school in time. So when there is a duty, you know, ye karna chahiye, ye nahi karna chahiye. You must speak truth. You must respect your elders. You must remember the advice of elderly. So this is moral obligations. When we talk about moral obligations, we use must. Okay? So it is also used to express compulsion. Jab kuch karna hi hai, ordering someone to do something because it is necessary. There is necessity. You must answer. This is written na? Give answers to all the questions. It is must to give answers to all the questions. You must return by the evening. It is used for saying that something is probably true because nothing else seems possible. Then negative form of must not. You must not come here. You must not use the office phone for private calls. Again, this is obligation. Or very important use of must is while giving advice, emphatic advice. Emphatic means empathy. When we keep ourselves in the place of others, ki haan meri tabiyat kharab agar aise ho jaye to jaise uski hai, in that way empathy. When we give empathetic advice to others, you must see a doctor, you must visit a pediatrician, you must work hard if you want to get good marks. Fine, you must prepare harder for your competitive exams. Emphatic advice. Then we have to. Fine, beta, must ka sabko clear ho gaya. Now we have to. Have to like must expresses obligation in the present while had to does it in the past. We have two forms of have to. One is have to. This past form of have to is had to. When there was obligation in the past, then we will be using had to. When we will be having the obligations in the present time, then we will have to. We will use have to. Example dekhte hain, chaliye. Yes. You have to obey my orders. You have to follow the norms. Clear? They have not written here. Have to express obligation and necessity in the present. You have to complete your work today by all means. Necessity in the present. Clear? Had to in the past. She had to take all those pills to get better. Clear? She had to eat medicine to get better. In the past. Had to in the past. Have to when there is obligation in the present. Bas itna yaad rakho. clear, and there is necessity of something, then we use have to and had to. When necessity of something in the past, had to. When necessity of something in the present, have to. Very easy way to remember this. Then we have very important modal verb, that is should. What use hota hai? This is like on priority basis we use this, and in conversations also, when you are when you talk about the spoken English, this modal verb is used very frequently. Should is the past form of shall. Fine. This is the past form of shall. Shall, should. Fine. See, I shall go to school tomorrow. I said that I should go to school the next day when we convert it in the reported form. But we will just see the usage of should rather than seeing this. Let's see the usage. Should is used to express obligation and duty again, the way must was used, beta. So here, you should pay all your taxes. You should look after your old parents. Clear? Should is also used to give advice or suggestion to someone. First usage is obligation. A keywords likh lo. First is obligation. Second keyword is advice or suggestion. You should consult a doctor. You should do yoga exercises daily. You should learn English if you want to get good job. Clear? Now, I won't be beta telling you all the usages, because there are one modal verb is having n number of usage. We will be doing the most quite oftenly used ones, right? So should is remember for obligation, for advice, for suggestion. Let's move to next verb, that is need. First thing to remember about this modal verb is this is used along with infinitive to. Clear? Need to, need not to. Now let's see the usage. Negative form is need not. Now, this is the need is used to express obligation or necessity when there is dire need to do something. In that way, you need to see a doctor. There is dire need. You need to attend your online classes every day. Fine, in that way. And need he solve all the sums? Need I attend the class today? Need he solve all the sums? Fine. In interrogative form. Now, in this case, we have to put to. Need not plus perfect infinitive is used to express unnecessary action. You need not have carried an umbrella as it was not raining. You need not have gone to see the doctor. Have is used with her. So when there is see, the modal verb need is mainly used in questions and negatives which are formed without do. Need I now, you need not go. The negative need not is often shortened to needn't in conversation and informal writing. Clear? So the basic usage of need is in question and in negatives rather than in affirmative. Basic use. Needn't. You needn't go there. You needn't talk like that. You needn't do this. You needn't do that. Now let's move to next model. Before moving on, send me thumbs up if it is clear to you. I would be naming the students who are listening to me. Divya, Titiksha, Ryanshika, Parmeet, Dipt Kirti. Yes, keep on sending thumbs up so that I know that you are listening to teacher. Jia, Prachi, find same students on daily basis. So usage is clear. You have done this. I have already taught you in class 7th, you remember? We have done this. models in detail, but this is the revision only. From 6th onwards you start this topic, and it in all the classes it is there. Now next modal verb beta is ought. Now firstly remember one thing about ought is also followed by infinitive to. Ought to, it is a set only pair. Ought is usually followed by to and an infinitive. You ought to tell the truth. Infinitive is first form of verb here. To plus first form. We never use second or third form of verb after infinitive. After this to. Clear? You ought to tell the truth. It does not change its form so that the third person singular form does not end in s. Ought to does not change its form. Bas itna yaad rakho. She ought to work a little harder. Clear? Now, where to use ought usage? Ought to is used when we believe strongly or expect that something will happen. When there is strong, you can say, opinion of something or strong possibility of something. The Indian team ought to win. Satish ought to pass. The meeting ought to have finished by 2 o'clock. Clear? When there is strong obligation. Otherwise, we get confused where to use should, where to use must. Ye sare same hi lagte hain. Fine, but they come from same family. But when there is strong necessity, then you will be using ought. While talking casually and all, we preferably use should. Fine? In that way. Now, I was talking about that when we get confused, that ought is also used for obligation, must is also used for obligation, should also, have to also. Why? So note, let's read this. बहुत जरूरी है ध्यान से. Ought is used to express the subject's obligation or duty. Fine. Whenever we use ought, it expresses the subject's obligation, subject about which we are talking about. But it indicates neither the speaker's authority as with must. Fine. Subject has nothing to do here in the case of ought. But in the case of must, yes, speaker, subject. He has the authority, then we use must. Nor an outside authority as with have to. When some outside authority is there, when teacher is saying you have to do this, fine, there is no inside authority. Getting my point? When some outside authority is applied, then you will be using have to. When you have no option left, koi kaam karna hai, aapko karna hi hai. Outside authority has said, so have to is used. Clear? And should, same way ought is used while giving advice, a sensible advice to someone. You know, you should dress up nicely, you should eat healthy food. A sensible advice when we are giving to someone, then we use should. That's why I told you we use should quite often. Clear? So this is the difference. Now, beta, you won't be solving this exercise. Your homework is, you will be doing from grammar book only. Kindly note down page number 212 of your book. Exercise number 3, I will put in the group also. Clear? Exercise number 3. Exercise 2 is already solved, beta. Wo solve kyu hui hai grammar book mein? Aapne unsolved wali karni hai. Page number 212, exercise number 3. Three parts are there of third exercise. 1, 2, 3. All the parts you will be doing. Clear? Bell has gone, beta. I need to end this meet. But we will continue with this model auctionaries tomorrow, because it will take 2 lectures. Obviously, more models are there. सो कंटिन्यू करेंगे कल मॉडल्स एंड वी विल कंप्लीट होपफुली. ओके बेटा, एंड फ्रॉम मंडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल स्टार्ट विद राइटिंग स्किल. फर्स्ट ओनली वन राइटिंग स्किल इज लेफ्ट आई गेस. एंड यू विल बी सेंडिंग योर नोटबुक्स टू मी. टुडे आई टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी दैट रोल नंबर 1 to 46 स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर. सो रोल नंबर 1 to 23, fine, 1 to 23 will send today in that notebooks group. Don't send personally, fine, because sometimes we are not able to find and locate and check. Everybody has done homework, and roll number 24 onwards till 46 they will send me the next day, clear? Saturday. I hope you have completed your work and definitely be ready to get the stars also. Have a nice day.